Yo, what up, everybody? It's your favorite Green Eye Bandit, and we are in the Green Room Studios, and I'm just gonna answer your question that I frequently get asked in the lab when a producer or a creative comes through and they see my setup. First thing they say is, which DAW do you like to use? Like, if you've seen my setup, you see I've got the Maschine Studio by Native Instruments. I've got FL Studio. I've got Logic, and I've got the MPC X. And the question becomes, which one do you like best? Which DAW do you like best? Now, I've used everything except Ableton and Cakewalk. I just never got off into those formats. I've used Studio One, I've used Reasons before, and all of those are great. I've actually gotten placements using Reasons just because Reasons Fluidity was just really fast and I was able to create really quickly with it, and different sounds. But out of the setup that I have now, I find myself at this current time using Fruity Loops, then my MPC X, and then the Maschine. But again, it interchanges, and then Logic or whatnot. Now, I use Logic, and you know, I use Logic pretty often, but they all have their unique differences when it comes to how you create. So at times, I come from MPC 3000. Like, that used to be my main production tool. So I love when I use the MPC X because it's a standalone tool. I don't need anything else, just that. I don't need a computer, and I don't have to look at the screen, like up at the screen of a computer to get done what I gotta get done. With Logic, you have to look at a computer screen. With FL Studio, you gotta look at a computer screen. With the Maschine, you have to look at a computer screen. And to me, that makes me produce with my eyes and then my ears. Fruity Loops is a produce with your eyes and your ears first tool. Currently, that is the most active one that you have to see what you're doing and then go, you know, and process it from that point. Logic, because you have to use a computer, again, it's still, you see it and then you produce with it. The MPC X, I can take that, like I said, without a computer or whatnot, and just use its onboard setup and go ham. I've installed the SSD drive inside of it so that all my sounds are in there. Now, that's the only reason why I got rid of my MPC 3000, is the portability and the ability to import sounds wasn't as fluid as FL Studio having all my sounds in the computer and on the drive when I pull it up, as Logic in the same way as the Maschine. The Maschine is less of a tool for me because you have to carry the Maschine Studio or MK1, 2, or 3, you gotta carry it with you to work, you know what I mean? Now, I know some people say, well, you can run Maschine like you run FL Studio, but you can and you can't, it's not as fluid. And again, all these things that I'm discussing lead back to the one thing that should concern you the most, is workflow. That's why FL Studio is everybody's tool of choice at this point. Man, it's so easy to move around in FL Studio, and I find myself going back and forth between FL Studio and my MPC X because MPC X is even faster than FL Studio once you pull up the sounds you want to use. Of course, you can pull up a template, you can create a template in any of these units so that you can get right to work, but that's the most important part. Now, aside from that, the edge goes to MPC X when it comes to feel. Why? Because I don't have to see it to catch my vibe. With the MPC X, you listen with your ears first, and then you can choose to edit or do whatever you need to do with your eyes involved as well. But that was the whole point behind producers who use the MPC X. It's the feel of it. The reason why Kanye still used the ASR-10, it's the feel of it. I owned an ASR-10 as well, and that was the purpose behind it. It was the only standalone synthesizer that you could sample while monitoring what you had going on. Most times when you sample, it'd stop everything else, and then you'd have to sample and then import that into the, you know, the sequence or whatever. MPC X is the same way. I can have my beat going and the whole groove happening, and just sample, you know, and then pick it up and put it in the mix how I want to, which is a really, really strong tool when it comes to, you know, your creativity. So if I was to choose one and then I had to get rid of the rest, I would use my MPC X for production. Now, just strictly on production, I'd use my MPC X, then FL Studio, then Logic, and then maybe the Machine. Now, mind you, the increments between these are very small. Sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't. That's how I explain which one I'll be operating on for that moment. It's which one gives me the feel of whatever I'm working on, right? MPC X is more action. Like, it's gonna happen. I'll be able to sequence my whole song out in a breeze. FL Studio and Machine, to me, are tools of creating a pattern and then looping that and then making your adjustments, while Logic, you're actually building the song. Like Studio One, you're building the song. Reasons, you're building the beat, you know what I mean? And I've got to dive into FL Studio in regards to actually producing vocals in it. I've never done that. You can produce vocals in the machine, in the MPC X, which I still got to dive into that as well, because my tool for vocal production is Pro Tools. It's like the industry standard. And I know people use Logic as well. I don't. Pro Tools is my choice when it comes to recording people's vocals and whatnot. I just like it as a tool. I love that the way I can move around it. It's been around longer and it's just more of a foundation for my production. So those are a couple of the DAWs that I like to use. What DAW do you like to use? And I want to tell you, there is no right or wrong answer. Everyone can contribute to the musical landscape by studying whatever equipment you decide to use. Just be dope at it. You know what I mean? Just be really, really good at it. And YouTube University can help you with that. There are so many people on here who can give you, you know, some advice on how to fine tune something or whatnot. Now, mind you, a lot of them don't give you all of the answers. You will have to do a lot of research and patchwork some of this stuff together so that you can have a cohesive way of doing things. But if you do your due diligence and you study and you learn more about your craft and you ask questions, go to your local guitar center, Sam Ash, wherever you buy your equipment or whatnot, ZZ Sounds or Sweetwater, wherever, ask some questions. Hey man, I'm trying to learn how to sequence this and do that. Is there a shortcut or key command or anything like that that you could tell me that I could use to do it? So there are ways to learn it outside of reading the manual, and you know, you get helpful hints, tricks, tips from people like myself and other producers on YouTube. If you like this, subscribe, press the like button, tell somebody about it. And if you got deeper questions about any of the pieces that I use and again, how I use them and how they all dance together and whatnot, you know, you can hit me up and ask me any questions about that too. Trying to build up this channel so that I can be more of a information base for people. And I'll do stuff on each one of them, and maybe it'll be like one day I'll have, you know, this is how I use the MPC X when it comes to sampling, or this is how I use the machine when it comes to sequencing a song. This is Logic and how I manipulate the sounds and how I like to tweak, whatever, you know, it'd be a bunch of different stuff like that. But tune in, subscribe to stay tuned and whatnot, and we'll chop it up later. It's your boy, IC Green. Now, if you want to look me up, my production name is Scrap, S-K-R-A-P-P. If you type that in Google, you can kind of see some of the work that I've done and who I've done it for and on what level I've done it. But if you don't, just stay tuned, man. I'll show you some things. We'll learn together. We'll grow this channel as well as grow you as a music producer. I'll give you tips on writing, vocal production, as well as how to use some of these tools that you see behind me in the studio.